Hello, my name is Christophe Dujanic, and I'm the Chief Product Officer at Blackfire.io. In this video, you will discover a full demonstration of Blackfire. We will see how it can help developers understand how their code behaves and how to improve its performance. Blackfire is a PHP performance profiling and testing tool. It enables you to have detailed information on how your code is being executed and how it consumes resources. Blackfire can safely be installed on any machine. We support Linux distributions, macOS, and Windows. Blackfire generates no overhead at all for end users. Thanks to our automated instrumentation technology, only the requests which are triggered for profiling purposes are instrumented. That's why it is fully safe to use Blackfire even on production servers. Let's take an example by running Blackfire on a demo application, GitList. This is a simple open source Git user interface. We deployed it on a production server where we also installed Blackfire's components. It is possible to profile this application in various ways. You can use the browser extension, where we support Chrome and Firefox, or you can use the command line with a simple Blackfire curl command. The result is the same, except that curl will give you much more flexibility and will support post requests profiling. More options to start profiling exist, such as via the PHP SDK or builds. Let's profile the homepage via the Chrome extension. Running a profile may take a few seconds or more, depending on your code. By default, Blackfire profiles your code 10 times, aggregates and averages the data to make it more reliable. Once the profile is available, we directly get information on the total wall time, I/O time, CPU, memory, network calls, HTTP requests, and SQL queries. By clicking on either of those dimensions, we will be displaying the corresponding call graph. The main advantage of call graphs is that such displays give you a lot of context elements and the bigger picture. The nodes in the call graph represent function calls. They can be called by other functions or call other functions themselves. Aggregating information in nodes enables to track down which part of the code is consuming more resources, but always in relation to others. For instance, we often get the question, how do I view only my business logic, not including the framework? Well, in many cases, you actually do not want to do that. Your code's performance may also be dependent on your usage of the framework. Not displaying how the framework is consuming resources because of your code makes you miss out on a lot of valuable information. So, how do you know if this call has been made before that other one? Or if the first call of some function took more time than the other ones of the same function? Because of its aggregating property, the call graph cannot answer those questions. The timeline view will be here to help. On the x-axis, the timeline represents single function calls when they happened since the beginning of the script execution. On the y-axis, calls are nested in their call stack levels, from top to bottom, so that you can also inspect the caller and callee relationship. As we do for the call graph, the 1% less significant calls are removed, which makes profiles lighter and easier to read. The timeline also detects special function calls and groups them by metrics, using colored blocks. This allows to quickly spot them by just looking at the legend. You can also click on the Filter Events button and keep only the significant colored calls. Metrics can also be user-defined, as we will see later in the demo. Let's look at our specific example on the wall times call graph. Color codes will help us determine very fast where is the performance bottleneck in our code. colored borders show the slowest path in the code, or in other words, the sequence of calls which consume the highest percentage of resources versus the other calls in the request. Colored backgrounds show the calls which, on their own, discarding any callee, consume a higher percentage than the others. The brighter the color, the higher the percentage. In our case, stream select comes first. It takes a significant amount of time to execute, a third of the total time. As stream select is a PHP built-in function, it cannot be optimized, but we can try to lower the number of times it is called. We'll have to climb up in a call graph through framework components to find the source of the issue in the Gitter client get version and Gitter client run nodes. The Gitter client get version method is called 10 times and accounts for 27% of the total execution time. That's a lot. Let's look at the code itself. Gitter is an open source library which we'll find on GitHub. Apparently, getVersion returns the version of the local Git CLI tool, as getPath returns the path to the Git binary. We can safely assume that this method will always return the same result for any given request, and most of the time even across requests. Caching the return value locally avoids running 10 identical subprocesses. Let's check if the result is satisfying. We've deployed the fix, and we will profile it. One of the greatest features in Blackfire is that you are able to compare two profiles and display the resources consumption difference between two different versions of your code. Everything that is in blue is a performance improvement. Everything that is in red, a regression. Here, the call graph clearly shows that our code's performance improved by 30%. And that's it. In less than 5 minutes, in a codebase we knew nothing about before, we've already found a performance bottleneck and written a patch. You can't optimize what you can't measure, and Blackfire is the most accurate PHP code consumption measurement tool on the market. But it provides even better ways to make sure that all of your code can be checked. It can be used as an automated performance testing tool, no matter what infrastructure, tooling, or workflow you might currently have. Meet the Blackfire builds. Blackfire builds provide a very flexible way to have your code's performance tested in any test, staging, or production environment, including in continuous integration workflows. Writing performance tests with Blackfire is as simple as creating a new .blackfire.yaml file in the root directory of an application. This file will be deployed with the code. It will contain the definition of your metrics, tests, and scenarios. Some simple tests can be written, for instance, on the wall time or on the memory. But assertions on these dimensions are actually very weak. Time is not a stable metric. External factors, such as machine load, can have significant impacts on wall time between two profiles of identical code. Volatile tests must be avoided at all costs, as they make your test suite less reliable and degrade the trust your team has in any failures. Blackfire comes with many built-in metrics, but you can also create your own. Gitlist makes extensive use of subprocesses to run Git commands. The following test will help us check the number of subprocesses executed by any Gitlist page. We will create a new metric which aggregates the cost of all Symfony process start method calls, and another one which also enables to group them by the command that was executed. That's also where you can simply add the timeline is true setting to view that specific metric in the timeline. In the same YAML file, we will also be able to determine a set of URLs on which we want to automatically run our tests. Manually triggering profiles on individual URLs like we did previously works well on development machines, but it doesn't scale well for integration, staging, and production testing. This is an example of what Gitlist scenarios could look like. Now that we defined our metrics, tests, and scenarios, we just need to trigger the builds. That can be done via periodic builds, for instance, if your code is in production, via one of our native integrations or via a generic webhook, which you can use with any of your tools. Anytime a new build report is available, you can be notified in various ways. It can be email, Slack, or HipChat. It can even be directly at the commit status level in GitHub, GitLab, or Bitbucket. Or it can also be via our webhook. Let's start a build. The build report will give us an overview of all of the tests we've defined in our Blackfire YAML file. For any failed scenario, you'll be able to have a look at the corresponding profile or the comparison with the previous build iteration. We can see that our test has failed. Also, with the new metric in place, we can see that running git version 10 times is a waste of resources. Now, an even faster way of challenging your code's performance will be with the help of our built-in performance recommendations. According to our expertise and our partners, we've written some default tests. We'll be able to let you know if your code doesn't comply with some of our best practices for generic PHP, Symfony, Magento, Drupal, Easy Platform, or Typo3. A full documentation is available to describe exactly why we set such a best practice and how you can solve the issue. If you're not sure where to start when writing tests, recommendations are a great head start. Simply start by adding a few scenarios in your .blackfire.yaml file and check if we detect anything. If we do, you'll always be able to copy-paste the code snippet at the end of the doc to build your first known regression test. This rounds up our demo. There's a lot more Blackfire can do for you, and we strongly encourage you to have a look at our documentation section at blackfire.io/docs. Should you have any issue, we'll be happy to help via our support site at support.blackfire.io. Thanks for watching. Have a good day.